April pranksters of Reddit, what do you have planned for tomorrow? I have taken a picture of my roommate's phone on the table. Tomorrow, I know for a fact she will be out. I will text her, hey, you left your phone at home, and attach the picture of her phone on the table. I'm definitely stupid enough to fall for this one. I've looked for my phone while FaceTiming on it. I'd totally fall for this. I've spent most of the last 2 days playing games on FaceTime with my brother and his family. You would not believe the amount of times I stopped to look for my phone after hearing a notification while simultaneously still talking on FaceTime on the dang phone. I stopped by my mom's house for dinner one night and forgot my phone when I left. When I came back to get it, I had a text from my mom. You forgot your phone. I just looked at her like, really? She said she realized as soon as she sent it. Mums are special. My mum once rang me to tell me that she'd send me a message, which said that she'd send me an email. My family has complained about the fact that some of our forks don't match. At one point my mom thought that a fork appeared out of nowhere, so I went to a thrift store and bought an assortment of forks and have put them amongst the other forks. I, too, like psychological torture. As a mom, can I say, this is effin' good. Don't do too many though. It has to be just enough that it's not obvious immediately. April Fool's Day technically starts at midnight. My husband finishes work at midnight and drives home alone. I work mornings, so I spend nights at home. I took the time to build a giant cockroach scarecrow in our kitchen, left the kitchen lamp on, and went to bed. It waits for him. I did a text replacement on my wife's phone. Whenever she types lol, it will be replaced with a Declaration of Independence. Nice. On his wife's phone, my brother replaced the word mom with magnificent baboon bottom. Good times. Around 10 years ago, I was running a hotel and had an active prank war with my head housekeeper. I put together a collage of weird photos of Nick Cage, printed them out and cut them apart, 190 in total, and numbered them 1-200 with a marker, skipping some numbers. I've long moved on from that company, but I still get a text from her every few months as she's found another one hidden somewhere around the property. Still hasn't got them all, though. Filled my in-laws' yard with rubber ducks, stuffed ducks, and other assorted duck items. Found UFs with duck salt. Walk around all day with my fly down and my shoe untied whenever someone notices. I'll reply with haha April Fools. I'm not falling for that one. I'm going to Krispy Kreme. Taking a picture of me at home eating a donut, and email it out letting everyone know I brought donuts to work. Evil. I love it. Print out a picture of Slash from Guns N' Roses. Tape it onto a friend car's wheel and tell them in a panicked tone someone slashed your tires. I have Play-Doh dried and measured to match sticks of gum. Whoever is stealing my gum will learn that, yes, I've noticed. My dad's current favorite flavor of Gatorade is the neon greenish yellow one. I conveniently finished the pickles the other day and saved the juice. Ever since I swapped out our company's logo for our competitor's logo on our intranet site, I no longer do pranks at work. As an educator, I have a quiz that I give to my students. It has 10 questions and I have one directive. If you're stuck, go into the next question. The first 9 questions make no sense and use big words. The 10th question says, this is an April Fool's Day joke. Quietly hand in your quiz for a prize. I bought some of the Cadbury Scream eggs from Halloween. They are the same chocolate shell but have green goo inside instead of white goo, and hid them, and the existence of them, for the past 6 months. We bought some normal ones yesterday because someone in this house actually eats the things. I am currently carefully unwrapping the normal ones and rewrapping the Halloween ones in the normal Easter wrapping. My identical twin and I are going to switch classes tomorrow. Hopefully they don't realize. Update. So I was thinking it was just a normal plan and it was all fun and games. I also really had trouble figuring out where my brother sat in class, and it really went well because nobody said anything or knew. So apparently my brother was called up to the office near the end of the day, which was me since I was in his place. I was called into the principal's office, which scared the shout of me, and then they started yelling at me because apparently I got into some school incident yesterday. This got to the point where he brought in the officer as well. At this point I said, look, for April Fool's, me and my brother switched places and you're meaning to talk to my brother, not me. He said, I know, April Fool's. I was really confused, and apparently my brother went and told him mid-school day. I envy identical twins on April Fool's. The opportunities available to you are endless. Even better thing to do as a twin is not swap classes but act weird and try and convince everyone you have did this with my twin a few times. Walk into class looking slightly confused and walk slowly to your seat. We had assigned seats. And sit down awkwardly. This is where my twin, I mean I sit. I'm going to write we have been trying to reach you about your car's extended warranty on a piece of paper and turn it in with the rest of my work to a few teachers. Switched the calendar to April in my preschool classroom, but turned all the numbers upside down. Going to go in tomorrow and pretend like I see absolutely nothing wrong with the numbers, then watch a bunch of 4- and 5-year-olds lose their minds. It's the little things. Update. Did it. I acted confused by them saying the numbers were upside down for a few minutes, then did calendar as normal while they all giggled through it. And yes, I did flipnate. I finally broke down and let them fix all the numbers after we were done with circle. They thought it was hysterical and no one was traumatized or permanently damaged. They've been getting me back all morning as revenge, telling me they're actually different kids, yelling look out there's a spider on your head, etc. It's been a very silly morning in our classroom. When the kids start freaking out, after you've been playing dumb for a bit, please say wait a minute you're right, and go over to an 8 or a 0 and flip it around. I like your style. My entire class is changing their Zoom pictures and names to our professor's picture and name. Okay, but if anyone says the professor's name you all have to respond like it was directed at you for maximum chaos. Oh, I love this. That's wholesome and funny. It would be even better if the professor was prepared somehow himself. Like IDK, a funny picture or a class picture or something. When I was in HS we would pick a random time in the middle of class that everyone would drop their pencil or book or whatever. I know teachers enjoyed it even if they pretended not to. Keeps things interesting. At the end of my shift, I will be placing a bunch of good jelly eyes around work and on people's photos. Each year second and third shift combined forces to dupe the first shift. I did this to a coworker. About once a week I would have the custodian unlock her classroom door and I would put googly eyes on one or two things. It went an entire school year before she figured out it was me. She would ask around to see if anyone saw something. She would post pictures on Facebook, and there were different theories on who it was. I was a quiet first year teacher so no one suspected me. She still has eyeballs on her computer. I got a professor like this really well. We had gotten along, both gamers and I was an ex-student at the time, but still came on campus for other classes and to shoot pool and stuff. About once a week, when I knew he would be in a class, I would go to his door and stick one of the Skyrim Dark Brotherhood We Know handprints either under his door, or tape it to his office or something. This went on for like 3 months then I stopped. About a year later I was visiting campus and dropped in to say hi, and he, I'm not kidding, I swear, goes random question have you been effing with my office? And I just looked at him and went we knew. I got jokingly cussed out about it, and we shared a good laugh. About 7 or 8 years ago my daughter and her husband went on a European cruise. We were tasked with visiting their house to feed and water the cats. On the day they were to return, we put googly eyes on every single thing in her fridge. My favorite was the sleeve of tortillas. Because it was slightly up against the transparent front of the drawer it was in. So it looked like it was begging to get out. Much hilarity was had by all. I made cutouts of cockroaches and placed them inside a few lampshades. Very real looking and appropriately sized for Texas. The most hilarious part is, I have misplaced one cutout so at some point in the future, after I've forgotten about it, I'll find it myself and freak out. Dude. I read it as I made cutouts out of cockroaches and I was like, IDK what that is but that's too effing far. I read that in a strong Canadian accent and it made sense again. Dude I kid you not the other day my sister was FaceTiming her boyfriend who was sitting in his home in the dark. He said he was hungry so he grabbed a large tub of oats that he had just stashed in his room for some time. He began eating them raw with a spoon. Don't ask me why. It's weird I know. But it gets weirder. Well after a few bites he notices that the taste is bad and he figured they must have spoiled. Well he turns on the lights and inside the tin there were small bugs crawling everywhere in the container. Like everywhere. My guy just ate a few spoonfuls of oats and bugs. And this dude literally said nice hit of protein your comment reminded me of that. Since I'm going to be attending classes through Zoom tomorrow, I prepared a video that I'll be playing during class that has me glitching out. my dog randomly appearing in the background, etc. I'll be playing FOSS video by having the green screen option on during class, and I'll have a green piece of fabric covering my camera. Tried it in a few personal friend calls. Works like a charm. I'm a teacher. Last year whilst we were in lockdown, Melbourne, Australia, I had my background as a video that was my normal house background, but every 5 minutes or so there was 3 different things on loop. It was me walking in, suddenly noticing the camera, then trying to slink back out. After that I'd appear from the bottom left like the Mortal Kombat guy, then I'd jump out from behind the half wall behind me trying to scare people and them jump back behind the wall. Some kids thought I had a twin. The more clued on ones recognized what was happening, but they always got a kick out of it whenever it appeared. Food coloring in the kettle. My parents often drink tea in the morning. They're really hard to prank on, so I hope this one works. 2 drops green, 1 drop yellow. Makes the best neon green you've ever seen. If they make large pots of tea, add more as you see fit. I made glasses of milk for my kids' breakfast that are actually white jello. I will be freezing the cereal. Put cereals in white jello. I'm gonna go to work and pretend like I enjoy it all day. Update. No one believed me. You savage. The timeless tradition of leaving a bowl half full of Skittles and half full of M&Ms. S&Ms. I like it. A couple years ago I went on vacation for a few days, and when I came back someone had done this to the candy in our office kitchen. Mixed up Skittles and M&Ms. Then sorted into several bowls by color. There was a little note that said, "Where is your God now?" Macaroni noodles under the nubs on the bottom of the toilet seat. Doesn't lift it high enough to be noticed, but makes a satisfying crunch when someone sits on it. Makes them think they broke the seat. Now I know what I'm going to do with that expired box of hamburger helper. Thanks. That isn't expired. That's aged. Don't waste fine dining on a prank. We did the same thing, but with those little poppet fireworks. The kind you throw on the ground. Little paper app tadpole looking things. A girl from Tinder is coming over for dinner. When she arrives, I'm going to tell her that my parents are coming and can't wait to see her. Joke's on you. A girl did something similar to me once and it was no April Fools and really weird. What she never shows, and you're the fool. I'm quitting my job. I'm known for being a prankster in the office, but this isn't a prank. Maybe they'll keep paying you. That wasn't a joke, I mean. Look at Milton Waddams. It could happen. I'm quitting my job. I'm known for being a prankster in the office, but this isn't a prank. Haha, you Danger Storm Panther. I know you're a great prankster, but it's been 1 year since you did the prank. So can you come to the office now? Then they can turn up on April Fools next year. I'm back. But that's just the next prank. Not the 1st of April, but on the last workday of 1999. Boy does it look funny to write that. We changed everyone in the office's Windows startup sound to REMS. It's the end of the world as we know it. The help desk got a lot of calls that day. I used to love swapping out the Windows shutdown JPEG with erasing hard drive JPEGs. I made a series of memes featuring our CTO. He comes into work every day a couple of hours before everyone else. Tomorrow when he comes through the lobby he will be seeing a slideshow of them playing over a Minecraft music background. I put crime scene tape around my boss's office and drew an outline of a body with chalk on the carpet. Then I just put on my best terrified face when she walked in. Dude, awesome. Turn the shower head to the right 90 degrees and sit back at enjoy as my half asleep brother turns the shower head on to be spraying right in the face by freezing cold water. Okay, I need to know this right now. Do people really get in the shower and then turn it on like in Psycho? I always turn it on while outside of the shower, and wait for the water to be right temp, then hop in. My husband gets in the shower and then turns it on. I found out after we were married. I manage a software support team. I put together a short, but convincing support ticket reporting unexpected behavior from a fictitious user, Julius Michael Hibbert, MD. Slightly obscure reference to an in-joke of ours. I included a link to a screen capture video where I click a few things in a seemingly specific order and the entire screen flips vertically. I waggle my mouse pointer frantically, at which point there's a Windows 10 BSOD for a few seconds. Followed by a April Fool's message from me, just waiting to send it until I'm sure everyone in the US is offline, so that the European folks are the first to see it on the 1st. I'm gonna put donuts in the houseplants and then exclaim, oh, the donuts are ripe. And then when my smart A kid doesn't believe me, I will show him the donut seeds and then talk him into planting more of them for later. Also, I'm cutting out a bunch of different sized D's and I'm gonna put them in a baking dish and cover it with foil. Sometime during the day I'll pull that out of the oven and ask who wants brownies. Then I hit them with the baking dish, BC they're idiots. Gonna get a big container ship and go to the Suez Canal and, softly don't. Absolutely nothing. Except give concerned glances to my target and or just give them a wicked grin. I'll let them convince themselves I did something to them, without actually doing anything. I've done it before and it is really effective. I set my alarm for 6 a.m. knowing damn well I don't have a job, but a homie will think it's funny. Update. I woke up at 6 a.m. Showered. Walked the dog. Ate a bowl of oatmeal. Nothing too heavy for a work day. Put on my suit. Then told my wife to have a good day as I walked out the door going to work before remembering I don't have a job or a wife. You should set the clock 2 hours back so you go in somewhere late. Show that a-hole who the a-hole is. I'm gonna cook Brussels sprouts and then put cake pop frosting and melted chocolate over them. Then let them sit. My family will come in and take a bite out of the Brussels sprout. I did this when I was a kid. Made a bunch of chocolate covered apple slices. Except some of them were onion. Well, we're going to be getting a ton of snow and I have these giant penguin feet I made just for this. Gonna go walk around the parks and trails and leave prints everywhere. Hopefully people will think there's a giant penguin out there. Teabag in my wife's shower head. Hooch is crazy. Not going to do the fake winning lottery ticket again. That was a pretty big credit card statement. I do all my April Fool's jokes on the 3rd so that nobody expects it. It's April Fool's for my parents, BC they live halfway around the world. I used to tell them how I wanted to get a little bit of filler on my lips and they always advised me against it. I use the recently trending pillow face filter on again, send it to our group chat along with just got few years done. I was hoping to get a reaction through text but my dad called me so quick and this is how it went down verbatim. Dad, what did you do to your face? Me. I just got few years done. It's a bit swollen now but it'll look nice. Dad, why would you do that? What if your face never goes back to normal? I died and called him on FaceTime to so he could see it was a joke. My mom sprinted so quick and was like, let me see eel mayo. She proceeded to tell me I was gonna text you and say they did a terrible job but didn't have the heart to tell you. Bless her soul. I work at a sex shop. Our radio gets a 24/7 Christian rock station. I'll be playing that all day. I'm going to pretend that I did my March timesheets for work and then when the manager asks about them tomorrow morning, I'll say, oops, I forgot to hit send, while I scramble to get them done. The joke is me. I am the joke. You are me. Giant googly eyes on my parents' Roomba. Sometime last year, my girlfriend accused me of getting out of changing the toilet roll by leaving a single sheet on the current one and using a hidden one until she changed it. So since then I've been saving all the toilet rolls with a single sheet so I can leave them all in the bathroom for when she wakes up. This speaks to me on a spiritual level. Please update your post with the aftermath. He'll be single in about 12 hours. This is great. You should have left one on the toilet paper holder. Then hid all of your full rolls and put the other single sheet rolls wherever you keep your toilet paper. That way when she goes to change it, she's left with nothing but the single sheet rolls. Installed a program on my mom's computer that replaces all of her photos with photos of Nicolas Cage who she hates. Hey, this reminds me of a time about 8 or so years ago on April Fool's Day. My sister had replaced the background of the family computer with Nicolas Cage, who my mom also hates. My mom was not pleased. I printed out a random warranty contract and I'm gonna go up to random people saying I've been trying to get back to you about your extended car warranty. This is pretty good. I hope you do it and I hope it gets some laughs. Start a rumor that Volkswagen has changed its name to Volkswagen. Oh crap. They beat me to it. I'm going to bake a cake for my English flatmate with Union Jack decorated on it. And when he cuts into it, the inside will be the Irish flag Shyark Fadal RBS. Teacher here. I always put up a list of hilarious missing library books for my 8th graders. X. Josh. Big Changes. The Teenage Boy's Guide to Health. Erin. How to Breed Hamsters. Devin. Gotta Catch 'Em All. P. Poke Guide 2019, Haley, Beginner's Guide to Quantum Wave Functions, and so on. Tied a plastic rat to the bottom of the office lady's chair so when she pulls it out tomorrow it looks like a rat is scurrying out. Art. Say that microphone doesn't work in the Zoom class by turning my microphone on. Carrying classified massive objects, a smoothie. Please don't fake sneeze cough on strangers, not like last year. I have horrible allergies, and at my first job out of college my boss would grumble about how much Kleenex I used and tease me about how gross it was. We were and still are good friends, and joked around quite a bit. On April 1st that year I took some Kleenex to the break room just past his office and made loud sounds like I was blowing my nose, then doused the Kleenex in wet, sticky hand sanitizer, like a lot of hand sanitizer, walked back to my desk and as I was passing his, I casually tossed it to him while asking if he would throw it away for me. He freaked out, jumped out of his chair and flung it across the room. Whole office loved it, including him once he realized he was not holding ounces of snot. Melt crayons. Shape into starburst sized squares. Put squares in starburst wrappers. What kind of monster are you? A marine? Found Satan. I replaced all the pictures of Jesus with pictures of Kenobi in the local church cafe.